Welcome to Wagon Train Wednesdays, presented by The Archway.
During his 1820 expedition to the land that would later be called Nebraska, the Army explorer Major Stephen H. Long noted the lack of timber on the plains. He called the area the Great Desert and described it as uninhabitable by a people depending on agriculture for their subsistence. When the first pioneers did decide to settle in Nebraska, they quickly snapped up the land along the Platte River to be sure they would have a ready water supply. Then they built homes out of the material they had at hand. They didn't have logs or bricks, so they used sod. The deep and dense roots of the prairie grasses made the topsoil on the Great Plains a sturdy building material. The old-timers first cut the sod into bricks the hard way, with a spade. Technology made the job easier in the 1880s with the introduction of the breaking or grasshopper plow. These new plows were designed to cut the sod into strips that were 12 inches wide and 4 inches thick. Then, using a spade or corn knife, the do-it-yourself home builder cut the strips into 3-foot lengths. The sod was then stacked, first lengthwise and then crosswise to make the walls solid. The sod was always laid grass side down. Pioneer families usually lived in their sod houses for 6 or 7 years. If the exterior was finished with whitewash or stucco, the houses could last much longer. An early builder named Uriah Oblinger described his house as measuring about 14 by 16 feet inside with walls that were 2.5 feet thick. In a letter to his wife, who would join him after the house was complete, he asked if this would be room enough. If not, he offered to build a bigger house and to use a smaller one for a stable. The thick walls were sturdy, but they also provided excellent insulation. They helped the house stay cool in the summer and hold much of the heat from the wood stove in the winter. But the lack of available firewood on the prairie made feeding wood stoves a challenge. Again, the pioneers made do with the material they had at hand. They could burn hay, straw, and sunflower stalks. But the most plentiful fuel on the prairie were chips. It was a polite way to refer to dried buffalo and cow manure that was gathered, stacked, and burned in the stove. Much of the food that the early Nebraska settlers ate was homegrown. Vegetables were grown in gardens and stored in root cellars. Corn was a staple of the Native Americans who first called Nebraska home, and it has been grown here ever since. Cows would provide milk and cream, and home-churned butter was always on hand. Meat was a special treat. Because there was no refrigeration, it had to be smoked, salted, or dried to keep from spoiling. We used to have jerked buffalo, dried meat that a man could put in his pocket and could chew on all afternoon, said an early settler named William McDonald. Could your family live in a single room that measures 14 by 16 feet? You can imagine what it was like when you visit the Archway's replica sod house. It's just a little way up the hike bike trail from the bridge that crosses the pond on the Archway's north side. The house has a dirt floor, a bed with a rope frame, and a single window facing the east. It's modeled after the house that was built by the O'Brien family, the great-great-grandparents of former archway educator Ronnie O'Brien. I had the window put in just like how Ellen O'Brien put hers in, facing east, so she would be able to see the wagons coming, said O'Brien in an article in the Kearney Hub newspaper. The setting is perfect for the trails and for what we're trying to interpret. The houses were built between the trails and the river, so that as people were going through, you could trade with them. That is how these early settlers survived, she said. Learn more about life in the sod house, get these books at your local library, or online. Sod Houses on the Great Plains by Glenn Rounds, and Sod Walls by Roger Welsh.
Find more videos in the Wagon Train Wednesday series on the Kearney Archway YouTube channel. Be sure to follow the Archway on Facebook to see future Wagon Train Wednesday videos.